this video, let's look at sum number 6 of rectification of errors, standard 11, Samachir Kalvi textbook. So this sum goes as rectify the following errors which were located before preparing the trial balance. So we are going to give the rectification entry for this particular sum. So the first transaction in it goes as wages paid rupees 2000 for the erection of machinery was debited to the wages account. So the concept behind that particular transaction is any kind of repairs or maintenance charges or anything done regarding an asset will be recorded along with the asset, debited to that particular asset account. But here what they did wrongly was they debited wages. So the entry became wages account debtor to cash account. But correctly what it has to be done was machinery account debtor, because it was towards erecting a machinery account debtor to cash account. So if here you see cash account and cash account is in the correct place, so you can cancel it. Now actually in the correct place machinery must be there in the debit, but wages is here. So in order to take away the wages, we are going to bring it down to the credit and record the machinery correctly in the place. So it's going to be machinery account debtor to wages account as a rectifying entry. So we're going to take this and write it in the fair copy. Therefore, the journal entry is machinery account debtor to wages account for the 2000 rupees and the narration being wrong debit to wages account rectified. So let's move on to the next transaction. Sales return book was short totaled by 1000. So short totaled in the sense it is undercasting. So let's go to the working side and see what is actually happening. So here the sales return book is undercasted, and the sales return book has a general nature of debit. Therefore, when it is undercasting, it has to be recorded over there. It has to be debited, and it is still undercasted. Therefore, in the rectification entry also, we are going to debit the sales return and rectify it along with the suspense account. So the rectification entry for the second transaction, sales return account data to suspense account 1000 rupees, and the narration is being sales return book undercast. So let's move on to the third transaction. Goods purchased for rupees 200 was posted as 2000 to the purchase account. So here that particular purchase account is being overcasted. Actually the transaction was only for 200, but they have recorded it for 2000 rupees. So 1800 rupees is extra in the purchase account. So it is an overcasting of purchase account. So let's go to the working and see how it is done, and then we can come to the fair copy. So here the purchases account is being overcasted, that is excess of money has been recorded, it's been overcasted. Therefore purchases usually shows a natural debit balance. When it is overcasting, then we have to bring it down. Therefore purchases account should be credited in order to rectify. Therefore in the rectification entry we are going to use suspense along with it, suspense account along with it, to credit the purchase account. So the actual entry is suspense account data to purchase account, the rectification entry. Now here the amount is they have recorded 2000 rupees in the purchase account, whereas they have to record only 200 rupees. So 2000 minus 200, 1800 rupees is the actual value which has to be recorded in the purchases account. Moving on to the next transaction, the sales book was overcast by 1500. So here the sales book has been overcasted. Sales book naturally shows a credit balance. When it is overcasted, we can correct it by giving it a debit. Therefore, sales book is going to be debited with the suspense account, along with the suspense account. Therefore, let's go into the rectification entry. So the actual rectification entry, sales account data to suspense account, which shows that the overcasting is rectified with 1500. So next, move on to the next transaction. Cash paid to Mukil rupees 2800, which was debited to Akhil's account as 2000 rupees. So let's go to the working and see actually what happened, and then we'll get back to the fair. So now the mistake what has happened is cash is been actually paid to Mukil. So actually the correct entry must be Mukil who is receiving it. So Mukil account debtor to cash account. But actually what happened is they posted it to Akhil account. So it happened to be Akhil account debtor to cash account as a wrong entry. So in both of these things, if you see, the cash account has been recorded correctly. So you can leave that out. Another twist in this is actual cash paid to Mukil was 2,800 and Akhil is recorded with 2,000 rupees. So you must actually give Mukil the correct debit. So it becomes Mukil account debtor. Akhil has to be recorded to the credit because he's in the debit. He is not supposed to be recorded in the debit. He is not there in the scene itself. Therefore, he has to be recorded in the credit. So it becomes to Akhil account. And the balance of this sum, that is 2,800 and 2,000 rupees, has to be rectified. So we include the suspense account. So let's see how this is posted in the rectification entry. So now the entry is Mukil account debtor, the actual person who is receiving it, to Akhil account who is not supposed to receive it. So therefore we have credited him now, and to suspense account to balance the difference of the amount. So now Mukil is supposed to receive 2,800. Akhil has already been debited with 2,000 rupees, so we are cancelling that 2,000 rupees. So always my debit must be equal to my credit. So 2,800 and 2,000 over here. So the excess of 800 will go into the suspense account. Therefore, my debit will be equal to my credit.